So this is the self start. These are the four cylinder. This is the four piston. This is the connecting rod that is connecting the crankshaft. Here, this is the crankshaft. This is the fuel injector. This is the alternator, and this is the fuel filter. This is the pilot lamp, and this is the on-off switch. So first, turn on the main supply. The pilot lamp will be turned on to indicate that the main supply is on. Now, with the help of this switch, we can start the engine. So the engine has started. We can see the pistons are moving. This is the wheel with the marking. This is, with the help of this wheel, we can find the valve timing diagram for four-stroke engine. The pistons are moving to the cylinder block. So during the first half cycle, when piston moves from TDC to BDC, intake of fresh air enters into the cylinder block. This is the first stroke, that is intake. After that, the piston moves from BDC to TDC and the air is compressed at high temperature and high pressure. At that time, the fuel is injected into the cylinder block, and due to the high pressure and temperature, it starts burning. After that, high pressure builds into the cylinder block. Because of this, the piston moves from TDC to BDC. At this time, the third stroke is completed, that is expansion. After that, the piston again moves from BDC to TDC, and the burning air exits through the exhaust valve. This is the fourth stroke, that is exhaust. Bring zero to this arrow, you can choose either BDC or either TDC, any one of them. So here, first I am choosing BDC, so position it at zero at this arrow, like this. Now we will start on the machine and we will see, observe when this inlet valve is open. This is the inlet valve and this is the exhaust valve. So we will mark the position on the wheel when this inlet valve is open. So start the machine and we can see that the inlet valve is open and the piston is at the BDC position. So this is the half cycle when the intake cycle, sorry, this is the half cycle when the first stroke is completed, that is intake. So fresh air has moved into the cylinder block. Now mark the position here from this arrow. We can see this is the position and note it down. Again, we will start the machine and we will observe the distance when this inlet valve is closed. So start the machine and note down when the inlet valve is closed. Now this inlet valve is closed. Check the distance here and note it down. Same goes for exhaust valve, like this. Turn on the machine and the exhaust valve is now open when the piston is near BDC. Note down the distance here. This distance is the capital D with the help of a formula that is given in the manual, that is angle equals to capital D by X, where X is the circumference of this wheel into 3600. We can get the angle at which the inlet valve is opening and closing, and same goes for exhaust valve, at which angle the exhaust valve is opening and closing. Now I am turning on the machine again. And this is the exhaust valve is open. So also note down this distance, and with the formula you can find the angle.